His speech was very strange. It was it was very like low key. I mean, I have to admit that I am pleasantly surprised with how much, although it is hilarious, they have still subsequently deployed like almost 10,000 troops or something like that. Right. Like, so it's like, in some ways, I'm like, I like that he's pushing back.
Our mission in Afghanistan was never supposed to have been nation building. It was never supposed to be creating a unified, centralized democracy. Our only vital national interest in Afghanistan remains today what it has always been, preventing a terrorist attack on America's homeland. I've argued for many years that our mission should be narrowly focused on counterterrorism, not counterinsurgency or nation building. That's why I opposed the surge when it was proposed in 2009 when I was vice president.
Awkward.
And that's why as president, we focus on the threats we face today in 2021, not yesterday's threats. Today, the terrorist threat has metastasized well beyond Afghanistan. El-Shabaab in Somalia.
So it's going to work.
I mean, it is funny. He's laying out like, here's where we are going to have.
I know exactly. Where everybody, do we invade next?
Everybody in the, you know, everybody in the military industrial complex, don't worry too much. We are going to be spending a lot of money on stupid wars for no reason. Don't worry too much, everybody.
We're just diversifying our portfolio.
Yes, we're moving around a little bit.
Yeah. So, guys, this is the game plan in case you want to know where we're going next. Here we go. Ready?
Don't worry.
The terrorist threat has metastasized well beyond Afghanistan. El-Shabaab in Somalia, Al-Qaeda in the Arabian Peninsula,
Syria, of course.
To create a caliphate in Syria and Iraq.
A caliphate.
And establishing affiliates in multiple countries in Africa and Asia.
Africa and Asia. We knew that, China.
These threats warrant our attention and our resources.
He's teleprompting
hard. We conduct effective counterterrorism missions against terrorist groups in multiple countries.
When?
Where we don't have permanent
military
presence.
When?
We don't have permanent. Okay, well, you know. We'll hey, listen, the way I feel about all this is I actually feel like so much of this speech is bullshit. But in the end, what he's saying is like, we're just going to stick with this and that's that. And I do have to stand with that.
Quickly
and decisively. I don't know what to stand with. Like, what's his other options? Like, oh, we're going to go back. I mean, it sounds like that's actually what he's doing because he's sending a bunch of troops.
It's true. Yeah.
Like, I don't know. I don't know if we have to hand it to him, like, for what, because it seems very clear to me, like, we need to pull out, but the way Biden did it seemed fairly disastrous and not the way he should have done it, where we were supposed to get all of, like, our spies and shit out, right? Like, they even getting him, like, they sent the troops back first, expecting the Afghan forces to stand up and protect, like, the embassies and all the thousands and thousands of informants.
And by the way, it really is like the media wants us back there like today. The media,
God,
I've never seen anything like this. And this week also, whenever I turn on MSNBC, and MSNBC is really bad about this in general.
Of course,
but every channel, they're just having analysts on saying shit that they're like, people are sending me on my phone. They're like, they're saying the Taliban is starting to beat women and I'm getting on my phone.
Oh,
I'm like,
why
aren't you like showing it on the air then? You're just saying you got it on your phone. There's so much misinformation going on about Afghanistan.
Article.
As someone who is a big believer, you know, in China's Belt and Road Initiative, and, you know, who thinks that perhaps, you know, the Taliban being in charge and China, you know, working with the Taliban will create, you know, a better relationship there. I like that they left all the spies and all the weapons there. I'm very happy with that they left a bunch of Tomahawk missiles and shit.
Well, not just spies, but it just seems like it seemed the way
the people are at risk.
Yeah, the way Biden did the pullout is as botched as anything else he's done during his entire administration. That should not be missed in the people who want us to stay there forever versus the people who just like there's a middle ground to say that obviously whatever the Biden administration does is going to do poorly. So pulling out the way they did several months after they were supposed to pull out, like what were they doing? What did he do differently than Trump? like in the intervening 6 months, like how is this any different?
Yeah, no one does anything. And I, one of the things I do think that, yeah, this Afghanistan withdrawal shows, and also everything in the Biden administration has shown, is, yeah, this idea of what Biden ran on and what Democrats like to sell of this, like, sort of utmost professional competency. I'm like, you guys can't fucking get right. anything done. Like, the Afghanistan withdrawal is totally disastrous, and it, especially as far as, you know, leaving people there and leaving a fucking bunch of military bases with guns laying around and shit like that. The same as, like, I think the COVID plan and, like, the eviction crisis, you know, has also been totally mismanaged. Like, between Trump and Biden, like, what we see is the White House doing nothing until the last minute and then being like, well, I guess let's just roll the dice. Fuck it. You know, like, they're like, I guess an eviction moratorium's gonna happen. Fuck it. They're like,
right.
Yeah, we have to withdraw by Afghanistan today. Let's go. Just go. Fuck. Like, yeah, just do it. I thought it was also really funny, by the way, the hubris of Biden trying to be on vacation and Jen Psaki being on an auto reply on her email the week that they fucking withdrew from Afghanistan. That is the funniest fucking most hubris I've ever seen.
Which is saying a lot for Biden.
It really is. It's so funny.
By the way, shout out to Lisa Mojica. He's Catholic. Yeah. Explains the botched
collapse. Viewers of the Katie Halper Show should be able to hold two ideas in your head at the same time. We need to leave Afghanistan, and Joe Biden screwed up leaving Afghanistan. Yeah, you should be capable of holding both those ideas in your head at the same time, even if no one else in the world can.
I mean, like, it is just like, if you want to be backed out by today, just start filling, you know, like, when you move apartments, you got to move the stuff. You know what I mean? Like, you got to just load all the guns into, like, I don't know, like bags or something. And
you move your TV before you move, like, your dump your trash.
Well, look, as someone who moved to college with trash bags.
That's what I used to move to college.
Exactly. Just use the trash bags at the very least, you know, throw a bunch of, you know, drone control devices into your trash bags.
Right.
Now, listen, I am speaking, and I like the chaos of the Afghanistan withdrawal, because I'm speaking as someone who wants to see the U.S. lose its superpower status. And so, you know, in a lot of ways, I think this being the most botched and ridiculous and obviously botched withdrawal has done a lot to sort of remove the idea that America is in any way a competent or threatening superpower. And I think that'll ultimately be good for the future.
Jack, that's the thing I'm scared. You just laid out the exact reasoning behind why we actually got into the Iraq war.
What?
Because our botched Vietnam experiment led the neocons to...
Yes, everybody got all revanchist.
We've just started the cycle over again.
It's Jack and George Bush.
George Bush died, but didn't Spain, and Jack is here.
Didn't Spain, when they were getting toward the end of their empire, didn't Spain have a bunch of wars where they just got their asses kicked over and over again until everybody just stopped taking them seriously as a world power? I feel like that's more where we're at now, is like, we literally, all we do, it's so funny, all we do is we spin the globe and we try to find literally the weakest army on the globe. We're like, the Viet Cong, that's the weakest one. We can't go to the Soviets, we can't actually fight against the Soviets, but let's go fucking fight. We can't even fight Cuba. We're like, Cuba's too scary. Let's go to the Viet Cong. They're just like in trees. There, we can do it. And we got our fucking asses kicked. The same with the Taliban. We were like, what's the easiest army on the earth? I guess the Taliban, they're these like guys that live in fucking caves that we sent like AKs to, like, it'll be nothing. And then we got fucking our asses kicked for 20 years until we lost.
Yeah, who would have seen that coming? Who would have thunk? Yeah,
well, the thing we must say is that we did not lose this war. The people who are actually fighting the war won, the military contractors. They got all their money.
That's true.
That was the point of this.
That is the point. Yeah.
They got the money. That's what the money is for. It's not about what was victory. I mean, Biden said himself, like, would even be victory? Like, Afghanistan is not, like, where we're going to build this Afghanistan, a country out of thin air. Like, our contractors, Blackwater, was going to build a country Taco Bell was going to build a country. Like,
also, by the way, they want them to be doing all those infrastructure projects here. So, you know, in Afghanistan, what they would do and what they did in Iraq too is they would like not fix a bridge, but they would pay like five different American consulting companies to all get paid on to come up with ideas for how to fix the bridge, but still no one would fix the bridge. So they want to bring that kind of infrastructure back to America. That's what this infrastructure bill is all about, is bringing the kind of infrastructure and nation building that we did in Iraq and Afghanistan right back here to the U.S. of A. And get those consultants paid to not fix the bridges here in America.